I want to talk today about resolution of a racemic mixture. And when we talk about resolution of a racemic mixture, we're talking about taking a racemic mixture, which is a mixture of 50% each of a pair of enantiomers. So I've got 50% of the S isomer and 50% of the R isomer. And separating isomers of enantiomers, so the SS enantiomer and the R enantiomer, very, very difficult. In fact, enantiomers have identical physical properties, so they can't be separated. So this S isomer, this S enantiomer, can't be separated from this R enantiomer. We need to do something to these so that they're no longer enantiomers, and then we can separate them. Well, one of the things we can do for a pair of enantiomers like these two that have a basic functional group in them, like an NH2, is we can react them with some sort of chiral acid. In this instance, we're going to use tartaric acid, and we're going to use the RR enantiomer of tartaric acid. And since this is a base and this is an acid, the acid is going to protonate my base, it's going to protonate this base, it's going to protonate this base, and we're going to get the acid-base salt as the product. And let's look at what those products look like. The S isomer reacts with RR tartaric acid to form this salt. You can see the protonated amine and the deprotonated acid. It gives me the SRR salt because I've got three stereocenters here. The R enantiomer of my base reacts with my acid to give me this salt, which is the RRR particular isomer. Now, what I want you to notice about these compounds, these salts, they're no longer enantiomers. The RRR enantiomer would be the SSS isomer. So the RRR and the SRR isomers are not enantiomers, they're diastereomers. And unlike enantiomers, diastereomers have different physical properties. So these two salts, these two diastereomers, have different physical properties. In particular, we can look at their solubility in methanol. SRR diastereomer is less soluble in methanol, and the RRR diastereomer is more soluble in methanol. What this means is if we try to do a recrystallization of these two salts, most of our crystals, or a higher percentage of our crystals, are going to be the less soluble SRR isomer diastereomer, and we will have effectively enriched our product in the less soluble salt. And by this means, we'll be able to separate the S isomer from the R isomer. Looking at what we're going to do in a little bit more detail, after we make these two salts and we do our recrystallization, we take our crystals, which again are more enriched in the SRR diastereomer. We don't want the salt, we want the pure amine back, so we're going to have to do a few extra steps. We're going to take our salt, which is again mostly SRR, and we're going to react it with sodium hydroxide. If we react it with sodium hydroxide, it's going to remove the extra proton from this amine, and what we're going to end up with is amine, which again is going to be mostly the SRR diastereomer, and the sodium salt of tartaric acid. I've written the monosodium salt, but we're going to add excess sodium hydroxide, so it's probably the disodium salt of it. But anyway, we're going to have to separate these two, and we're going to separate them based on their solubilities. This is a ionic it's ionized, it's got a minus and a positive, it probably has two of them. So this is going to be water soluble. This neutral organic compound is going to be water insoluble. So what we're going to do is we're going to extract this mixture, we're going to add water, and we're going to extract this mixture with ether. This compound, our neutral amine, is going to end up in the ether phase. The salt of tartaric acid is going to end up in the water phase, so we'll have effectively separated the two. And after that, what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to purify it a little bit more. So we're going to do a distillation, and then we'll determine the optical purity by measuring the optical rotation. I'm not going to talk today about how we use the optical rotation to determine the percent of the correct isomer, but by measuring its optical rotation, we can figure out how much we enrich this in the desired enantiomer, or diastereomer, I should say.